Today I want to talk about the relationship between closures and objects. The textbook definition of closure is a function with an environment, and we could define objects to be methods with state. And these look rather similar, and today we're going to show that closures can be simulated with objects, and objects can be simulated with closures. Okay, so here's the first example for closures. We have a function called add, which takes a parameter a, and it immediately returns another function that takes a parameter b, and then returns the sum of a and b. And the interesting part is that this function only defines b, that's why we can access b, but we can also access a, because a is in the environment of the function, and so JavaScript is smart enough to figure out how to store a long enough in this environment. That's where the environment part comes in closures. Okay, cool. So how do we use that function add? We call it with 1 for a, and then we basically get back this function where a has the value 1, so increment is a function. Then we call increment and provide the value 2 for the parameter b. And then, as the variable name indicates, we should get back 3. And the inline version is to say add takes an a, we provide 1 for a, then we get a function that takes a b, we provide 2 for b, and then we should get back 3. Let's see if that works. Indeed it works, and in some sense the only interesting part is here line 11, the console log. It logs an anonymous function, and if we wanted just to be sure that it's really this function, we could give it a name in JavaScript, and then we would see it's indeed this function that is returned. Right, and from a classic imperative programming language implementation point of view, it's interesting that a is still accessible when we call the increment function, because add has long returned and a should no longer be on the stack, and indeed JavaScript will hoist a from the stack into this environment, which is on the heap and lives long enough for the addition to take place much later. Okay, so how would we now simulate this example in a language without closures, for example Java before version 8? Well, we could say let's just write a class and instantiate that class. Then we have an object, and we can simply put one method in the class for this function. And then the environment, which only includes this a, we can just use the state of the method. Okay, so we would expect one field in that class. Let's see. That should be exactly what I did here. So we have a class called add instead of a function called add. The environment is stored in the object, just our a, and we use the constructor to initialize the a. So this is basically the replacement for the add factory function from the JavaScript example. Okay, and here now is our simulation of the return function, which takes the b. It's called apply as int because we implement this standard Java 8 interface, but you could have written a Java 7 interface yourself. And then here's the exact same method body where the A lives in the simulated environment and B is our fresh parameter here. Okay, and then instead of calling a function named add, we call the constructor of the add class. Then this system.println should print, you know, add hash code. Let's see, let's immediately run that. Right, add, and then the add sign, and then some hash code. And then on that object that we created here, we can call the apply as int method, provide 2 for the b, and then we get back 3. Indeed, that's the case. And the inline version calls the constructor and then calls the method on the new object. Okay, so this is how you would simulate closures before Java 8, and indeed that's what happened in older Java versions. You saw lots of this code, or maybe anonymous in our classes. Okay, so then let's look at a textbook example for a simple object-oriented class. So we have a class for accounts, which stores a balance. The constructor initializes the balance, and then deposit and withdraw change the balance by adding or subtracting from it, and then get balance simply returns the current balance. Okay, not too exciting, but hopefully understandable. Right, then we create the object, then we should get another account at hashcode. There we go. And then you can see after depositing 30 and withdrawing 7, the balance is 123. Okay, so how would we simulate this approach in a language without objects? So we're going to cheat a little, we're going to use JavaScript. JavaScript has objects, but I'm not going to use most of the object-oriented features, and we'll just pretend that it has dictionaries. Let's see. So again, we have a factory function, as in the very first example. The factory function takes the same parameters as the constructor in the Java version, and then we immediately return a dictionary or a hash map or a JavaScript object, but we're really not using it as a normal object. So what's inside this dictionary? So in case you're unfamiliar with this syntax, this is really just shorthand for saying deposit. So under the key deposit, we have the value deposit, which is this function. Okay, and then under the key withdraw, we have the value withdraw, which is this function, and the same for get balance. And the interesting part is that these functions are allowed to access the parameter balance from the outer function, and that's not a problem. It's just a shared environment. JavaScript will hoist this variable from the stack to the heap. Okay. So here we call the create account function instead of calling new add, and the rest is basically the same. Let's see if that works. Well, that should be account. Right. And then again, the interesting part is line 18, the first console log. What is this account dictionary that we get back? And here you can see the keys, and they are all mapped to functions, or in reality closures, because they have this environment that we can't see here. Okay, but depositing and withdrawing leads to the balance being 123. That's exactly what we expected. And I find this really interesting because you don't see any this in this example, right? So normally you would have to write this dot balance, this dot balance, this dot balance. We don't have new, instead we have just a normal factory function. None of this prototype and proto mess that you see in older JavaScript code. You don't see modern constructor or class keywords. Okay, and it still works. It's very simple and nice. Of course, the downside is that your JavaScript tools won't understand this idiom and won't give you auto-completion and such. But that's just a limitation of the implementation of those tools. And in theory, they could give you auto-completion. Okay, and what you would see in idiomatic code is a call to object.freeze, just to prevent client code from changing the object by adding or removing methods, right? That's what you don't want to see. And indeed, that's the only way to achieve similar safety as in the Java example. Move the state into the closure and freeze the object just containing these methods, basically. It's also illuminating to look at the code in the debugger of Chrome. So if I put a breakpoint, for example, into the, let's say, getBalance function here in line 13, and if we then copy-paste this code and execute it in the console, then we can see that here we have our local variables, and here we have our closure. Okay, and apparently the closure was created by a create account, and inside the closure we have our balance variable, which currently is 123. So definitely deposit and withdraw use the same balance variable. And I think that's interesting from a terminology perspective. So here the environment is called closure. That's interesting. So the textbook definition is closure is function plus environment, but Chrome uses closure for the environment, and sometimes closure is used for the function. So unfortunately, there's no standard terminology here, and it also seems to differ from country to country. So maybe let me know in the comments below, have you learned that a closure is a function with an environment, or do you call the function itself the closure, or do you call the environment the closure? That would be interesting to see.